Hello, everyone. So let's dive into this topic today. Like I said, it's quite a tough one to talk about. But it's important that we do. And the topic today is, a comment by one of my clients who said that, she felt like both her parents preferred her. Preferred being in relationship with her than with each other. So she had this sense of sort of being caught in the middle between both mum and dad. Now, in a previous video, we looked at the role that sometimes the daughter can take on of being the surrogate spouse to the father. So there can be sort of some secret sort of sexual liaison that meets the needs of the father. So this video today is a bit of a follow-on from this because some children, some daughters especially, can find themselves not only in an icky sort of relationship with the father, but there can be a similar thing with the mother. So without further ado, let's get going. So when we're talking about this preference by both parents for a relationship with the daughter. We're talking here about one parent being an overtly incestuous and the other being covertly incestuous. Now, it's usually the father who is the overt one, who sort of draws the daughter into a sexualized relationship. And the mother is the more sort of covert, emotional, one. So, just to sum it up, the daughter becomes her father's secret sexual desire, but she also becomes her mother's surrogate husband. Now, can you hear just in that statement alone how confusing this role is for a child? To be a surrogate sexual partner for a parent on one hand, but then also a surrogate spouse, intimate emotional partner for the other. It's a devastating role. It really is. I would say it's probably the most devastating of all roles for a child to be in. The child is used by both parents to meet their own needs. And the result is a total loss of identity in every way because the child is not seen for who they are, but what they can supply. There's that word supply. And we know how important supply is for narcissists and in a narcissistic family system. What results also, and this is my own thinking on this, so please don't take this to be sort of the latest research or anything like that. This is only my humble sort of understanding of what may be at work here. There's a great confusion that comes in for the child. I mean, how are they supposed to make sense of this role? Both parents are sort of using them as a surrogate spouse. And what results, I think, sometimes is either a hypersexuality. So in adulthood, the child goes on to be hyperly sexually aroused because there's this sort of sexual element in both relationships with the parent, or there can be a sexual confusion, which often results in perhaps a bisexuality because they're in a role where it is confusing between man and woman. This mirrors the role between mum and dad. So both parents subconsciously desire the child more than their partner. they desire the child in terms of their need to get their own spousal needs met, which they can't get in their spouse. So there's some kind of rejection between the two spouses. They turn to the child, usually the adult daughter, usually the daughter, and she then comes up, and on the one hand she meets the sexual needs of the father, but she meets the spousal intimacy needs of the mother. So these are both spousal, this role is, it's spousal, that they're spousal needs that are being met in the child. So that's where the sexual ickiness can come in with both parents, because a child's not meant to be in a spousal role. Okay, so why does this role even occur? And we've just touched on it here. Like I said, it's almost always the daughter, although it can be the sons, but most often it's the daughter. The daughter is seduced into a sexualized relationship with her father, because the wife doesn't actually want his sexual attention or his advances. She's rejecting him. And the father is intimate in the way he sees his daughter with lustful eyes, and she feels the ickiness with him. However, although that makes her feel a bit icky and shameful, on the other hand, she also invites the attention, because it's her experience of what it means to be loved. It's someone's actually seeing her, someone's actually desiring her, wanting her, and without that she may not feel it. However, the husband is using the daughter to make the wife jealous. On the other hand, the wife is both happy that her husband has been distracted, that she doesn't have to meet his needs, but on the other hand, she's also jealous. She's jealous of the growing attention that the daughter is garnering from him. At the same time, though, she may turn to her daughter as her confidant, her friend, her emotional rock, her husband that she always wanted. She will nurture the daughter in this role, talking about her husband and, you know, his sexual demands and, oh, your father this and your father that. She may divulge, you know, intimate secrets or intimate things about their sex life, or just sort of make him out to be a sexual predator. Which may be true. She may compliment and idealize the daughter, especially about the daughter's body. And even in time, she may sort of, you know, just tell her how she's not like her father, you know, almost glorifying the daughter's masculine traits over her feminine ones, because the feminine ones could mean competition. So she may say, oh, you're not like your father. You're so strong. You're so supportive. You treat me so well. But on the other hand, she may also say, you're just like your father. So selfish. So, you know, I don't know, quick-tempered or self-centered. Now, because the daughter feels shame, she does in her core about the attentions of her father and the jealousy of her mother, she may want to make up for it. And so she tries to be in the husband role for her mother. So she may try to be the husband that the mother never had in her actual husband. It may feel a bit like daughter and mother have a secret relationship of emotional intimacy, a secret intimate liaison, which should have been between husband and wife. The daughter in this context becomes a surrogate spouse to mum too. Not a parent. She's not being parentified here. There's a difference. She's being made a partner She's meeting the spousal needs of her mother, and the spousal needs have a sexual overtone. So the boundaries here for this child are non-existent. There is no protection in any relationship, it learns, with either man or woman that may not be subject to crossing the boundaries sexually. Now, where does this trauma express itself? Well, it expresses itself in our physical boundary, our bodies. That's where the drama, the trauma, the shame will begin to play itself out and express itself. Often what we see are eating disorders. The body becomes the battleground and the expression of shame. An eating disorder results from the sexually charged relationship with father, but also the covert sexual blurriness with mother. Food and weight obsession keeps the reality of this hidden behind body shame, because it's almost something that people cannot get to. They can't get to the cause of this shame, and then they can't actually put words to it. So what they do instead is they try to control the body, because with both parents, often there's the desire from the father, but there's also a desire from the mother, and for the body of the child, because if she's in competition with the daughter, who's slimmest, who's more attractive, she may feel that the daughter's got a beautiful body and she doesn't, and be admiring of it, and it all kind of plays out over the body of the child, and the daughter will try to maintain her competition with man, and her attractiveness from dad through controlling her body, because if she loses that, she loses her father's attention, but she also loses to her mother. So this will play out in adult life, you know, in relationships with other men and women. So she'll find herself exercising, you know, trying to lose weight all the time, constant dieting, binge eating, laxatives, purging, you know, anything to kind of control the body, but also at the same time to express that shame. And purging really is about that. It's trying to get rid of this body.